Welcome back. For many couples, the relationship can take a backseat to the needs of their children. This morning, some tips on how to rekindle that spark that brought you together in the first place. Dr. Marty Erickson, a developmental psychologist and co-host of the weekly podcast Mom Enough, is here with us today. And this is such a big issue. Parenting's stressful.
It is. It is indeed. And you know, these days people do what's called intensive parenting.
The
vast majority of parents. And so the schedules alone just keep you running all the time. And it's very hard to find time to really communicate with your partner and really keep that relationship going. And early on, when you first become parents, dads often feel kind of squeezed out,
right,
especially if mom's breastfeeding and just all that close contact. So it takes a lot of intention to really do this and keep your relationship going for your sake and for your children's sake.
Why is it so important for the kids too?
Well, because kids learn how to love and how to be in relationship from their parents. And they learn that by being loved and treated sensitively by their parents, but they also learn it from watching how their parents show affection and resolve conflicts and treat each other.
So Valentine's Day is as good a time to rekindle the spark as any. You have some tips?
I do. And the first thing, I really recommend that couples have date night every week. And you know, a lot of people are uneasy about leaving their child with a babysitter, especially an infant. I've specialized in infant development through my whole career, and kids can take that, and it's really good for the couple to have time alone.
Okay, and then the second is all about the routine, right?
Right, so it's having that connection on a daily basis, and that can be really small. Realistically, it often is. So sitting down after the kids are in bed and maybe spending just 30 minutes, you know, talking about your day, watching a favorite TV show, playing a game of Scrabble and keeping it going a little bit every night, whatever it is that you enjoy, but being intentional again about that connection.
And then the third thing, you talked about how kids really interact and see the way we treat one another. So how does that play into this?
Well, a lot of parents are really cautious about letting their children see them be affectionate in a physical way. And it's really good for kids to see that. I'm not talking about violating boundaries and you know, really deep intimacy.
Not TMI.
But the pat on the back or the kiss in the morning and the kiss goodbye, those things, kids really benefit when they see that. And when they see their parents laughing together and having fun together, because there are lots of shallow images of romance in the media and all around our children, and lots of very negative examples, and they need to see that even long-term relationships can be full of fun and romance, and they really can.
Well, what good advice, and I mean, you are the person to ask about this, because I understand you just celebrated your 49th wedding anniversary
with
your husband. I did.
Look at that picture. That was me with my long braids and my husband. We were kind of hippies in the early 70s, and this was us much more recently. We still love to be out in the mountains and canoeing and hiking and all of those things. That's us in Santorini in Greece.
So those are great pictures.
We've had wonderful adventures, and next year the big 5-0.
Oh, big one. Well, it's good to know that you speak from experience here.
I do, and the ups and downs. I don't want to idealize it because it's a lot of work to get to 49 years of marriage, but it's a lot of joy too, and you be intentional about that. It really is fun.
So what's coming up on your podcast?
Well, we have this week a guest, Alfie Cohen, a very well-known author who wrote a book called Punished by Rewards. Very provocative discussion about how rewards and praise can really not be the right thing for kids. And then next Monday we have more on healthy marriages, healthy relationships with Dr. Bill Cloke. He's an LA author and psychotherapist. So good stuff.
Thank you for being here. Great tips, things I can use
Maura.
In my life. So I very much appreciate that.
Well, fun to work with you.
And for all of those tips, you can go to our website, care11.com. We'll create a link to Dr. Marty's website on our 11 o'clock show page.